Welcome to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. Right now, I am sitting in the tour van belonging to a man called Asher Roth. I'm sitting beside him. I'd love it if you could introduce yourself.
What's up? This is Asher Roth hanging out in the Chrysler Town and Country. It's maroon. And it's got good pickup, you know, so I'm actually really thrilled with the van selection.
You've just put out a new record. It's called RetroHash. If we smoked some RetroHash, what would happen?
Pure bliss, man. Pure bliss and some good stories and probably eat some sweets. Just got back from Denver and they have these, I think they're in Portland too, voodoo donuts. Have you heard of voodoo donuts? Delicious, delicious.
RetroHash, it's a little bit of a departure from people who are used to your previous work. I'm going to play a song in a second. I'm going to play Tangerine Girl. Here's your chance to reintroduce yourself or introduce yourself. What would you like to say about this song?
My name is Asher Roth, and a Tangerine Girl is, you know, when you, the newness of a female, and when her body is sun-kissed, that is when a girl transforms into a Tangerine Girl. This is me talking about the newness and the sun-kissedness of the female.
We'll be right back.
What's up? This is Asher Roth, and you're listening to The Interview Show with Scott Wood.
Welcome back to The Interview Show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard Tangerine Girl by Asher Roth off his record, RetroHash. I'm sitting in his very hot tour van on a summer day right now. I'd love it, Asher Roth, if you could please say a little bit more about this track.
Tangerine Girl, I think, kind of represents RetroHash as a whole. We didn't go out and be like, oh, we're going to make an album. You know, we just had the opportunity. I had left the major label system and kind of put all that stuff to the side and just wanted to make music with my friends. So the Blended Babies, who are from Chicago, they produced the record in its entirety. And Tangerine Girl was one of the records where we're like, hey, let's keep making songs. Just went for a walk to Carney's and Deli and got some, you know, hot dogs and some root beer. And walking back and just kind of had this melody in my head. I was like, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. And then just kind of laid that down on the microphone. JP walks over, starts playing the bass. And the song just came together. It wasn't hard. It wasn't some stressful process, which I really believe making music should be. It should be fun. It shouldn't, you know, be turned into some whole rocket science thing. And I think Tangerine Girl really represents how we just made music that we liked.
So your first record, Asleep in the Bread Aisle, came out way back in 2009. Your second record, the current one we're talking about, came out in 2014. Where have you been, and what have you been doing?
I mean, in between those 5 years, definitely making music, but for the most part, just kind of untangling myself from the web. You know, it's tough whenever you kind of get in the music business, and I stress the business side of things because people have different agendas. And for me, I wanted to make music. Obviously, it's a beautiful thing when you can make a living off of it, but stuff that I really want to accomplish, and it seemed like those goals were getting farther away the longer I stayed in major labels. So I just put out free mixtapes. You can check out asherrothmusic.com and all the kind of stuff that kind of bridged the gap. And for the most part, just like getting a stronger relationship with myself, see what else is going on out there, moved around a little bit to New York, back to Philly, and then to LA, and finally settled in Los Angeles and made RetroHash.
You've lost your low-keyness. Before we started the interview, I was mentioning how low-key, calm, and centered Asher Roth was, but he's rattling all those answers off so fast.
I guess, man. I've had time to think about it.
When I met you before I started rolling the tape, it was almost as if you'd just come out of a yoga class.
I came out of a hot Chrysler van driving for 6 hours up the coast, so kind of the same thing.
So, problems with major labels have sidetracked many promising artists. How does one cope with that situation where you have a little bit of momentum and then things grind to a halt?
It's tough. A lot of pointing fingers goes on. But I think ultimately you got to embrace and accept responsibility on yourself. And I think that's something that I've been doing. Just kind of understanding the situation, understanding actually what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. For me, and RetroHash is kind of an example of it. I just, you know, rapping about myself and how great I am all the time and stuff like that, it just was like, okay, you know. And I just wanted to kind of challenge myself and songwriting and melody and just my relationship with music in general. So, you know, that kind of is just how I dealt with it. It was more just so getting right with myself than trying to, you know, pile more stuff on. I simplified the formula instead.
Have you ever thought of calling up somebody like Angel Hayes and having a bitch session?
Nah, I know. That would be pretty funny, though. Is she having her own issues?
Her first record was delayed by the record label. She got so angry that she leaked it.
Big Boy did that, too, I think, with Def Jam, yeah. This is no new thing, but that was the thing. Instead of digging myself deeper, I was just like, hey, screw this. Let's just get it where we can just put out music and then go tour. It shouldn't be that hard.
Hip-hop fans are intensely devoted, and they aren't afraid to speak their mind. What's something somebody said about you earlier in your career that stung that wouldn't even faze you today?
Oh, man, people have been calling me, like, you know, corny and a little bitch and all this stuff for mad long, and it just doesn't really matter. I think that's when you first do come out, you are kind of looking for acceptance, and then I think from experience, as you get some years on you, your skin gets a little thicker, and you're just like, yeah, none of that stuff really matters, and that's probably it. But all the name calling in the world, it stung early on, I'm not gonna lie, and it hurts, you know, but because we are human beings. But for the most part, none of that stuff really fazes me anymore.
How about we take a break where one of us rolls down the window?
Let's do that. There you go.
Awesome. Thank you very much for rolling down that window. There's going to be a bit of background noise now, but we will not die in the car of heat.
This is a real street interview right now. This is a good one.
All right, I think it's about time that we listen to another Asher Roth track. So, in a second, I'm going to play Fast Life off your latest record, RetroHash. I would love it that you talk about the featured artist on this track.
My brother Vic Mensa is on Fast Life. And again, just, you know, hanging out in the studio on the amp, just Fast Life, someone's always caught up in it. And he's right there. He just, like, starts going with it, you know, throws a verse down. Next thing you know, we have a track. So, Vic's killing it right now, doing a great job. Pleasure to collaborate with somebody who I've known for a while and watched do really well. So this is Fast Life off the new record, RetroHash.
Someone's always caught up in the... Someone's always caught up in a fast life. Someone's always caught up in a fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught up in a fast life.
Far too delicate. It's hard when a father is yelling it. Takes it out on her or the dark for the hell of it. Only 13 when she started developing. By 15, attracting the older gentleman. She let him in. Mom wasn't looking, she might have been. Turned a blind eye, thought it better than fighting with a little girl caught in a sinister world. No sibling or sister that could show her the pearl. So she turns to the night sky, drinking to get by. Pills above the sink that be helping her get high. All the while, she's forgetting to ask why. Feeling like the only way of living is let die. My goodbye's the hardest speech. Go along for the ride at the start of the speed. Through the rise and the fall and the valleys and peaks. While the heart tries to find what it needs. Don't get caught up in the fast life. Someone's always caught up in the fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught up in the fast life. Get up out your mama's basement. If I could buy my way to heaven or a diamond bracelet, can't help but wonder if my time is wasted. If I'm waiting on a train instead of trying to race it too fast.
My lady told me slow down, baby. By the way, it worked. My stepsister said, you know I'm crazy.
Hey, you gotta walk before you run. Gotta look before you leap. But lose faith before you preach. And just think before you reaching for the handle of your gun. And you running from what you done to become what you never wanted. 200, you on the run. Running from the sound of the sirens. Chicago, no violence. Nobody can tie me, come find me. I need an island to hold my family. Taking 10 roads at the Grammy seats. Granted, we've known each other for some time. It don't take a whole day to recognize sunshine. Look
fast
around.
Fast life. Someone's always caught in a fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught in a fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught up in a fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught up in a fast life. Someone's always caught in a fast life. Fast life. Someone's always caught in a fast life.
Welcome back to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard Fast Life featuring Vic Mensa off Asher Roth's record, RetroHash. I'd love it if you could talk a little bit about this track from your point of view.
Fast Life to me is just one of those things when I started singing it, I immediately thought of my homegirl who passed away from a heroin overdose, and I just thought it was so interesting because she's so smart, it was so beautiful, but she just got caught up in the wrong crowd, and it's just one of those things where I see a lot of the youth these days where I'm from, in Bucks County. Just a lot of kids mess around with pharmaceutical drugs and drugs that they don't really even understand what they're getting into, but just because they're bored. And I just was taking a moment where, one, to write a song from somebody else's, telling somebody else's story rather than telling mine. You know, talk about things where don't take this world for granted. You know, don't take this life for granted. A lot of these kids might come from money and stuff, and they have everything accessible to them, and they take that for granted. So just a moment for everybody to kind of slow down and appreciate what you have before it's gone.
Asher Roth, what is a hip-hop cliche that should go away? For me, I would love to see Let's Keep It Real go away forever.
Yeah, I would have to agree with that. Keeping it real is kind of all perspective at this point, and I don't even know what real is anymore. So I'm with you. I think keeping it real, Dave Chappelle did the When Keeping It Real Goes Wrong. I think a lot of people would be in agreement that the whole keeping it real thing can go.
You've said that working with friends makes you more comfortable to take risks. I'd love you to pick a track off the current record. Talk a bit about how working with friends has made you more comfortable to take this specific risk.
I think Tangerine Girl, Keep Smoking, even Fast Life, the ones where I'm kind of singing a little bit more. Typically I'll sing in writing sessions and write melodies and stuff for some other people. Working with friends allows you to take those chances in a non-judgmental, you know, environment. And they're close friends and really cool dudes. Blended Babies are a production duo. Rich was born in China. That's a fun fact about Rich. And JP from Minnesota. But they met in Chicago and honed their craft there.
You said that working with these guys, sometimes you just hang out, eat dinner, and go bowling. How do you remain disciplined while hanging out with your friends?
You just got to do it. You just got to be like, hey, guys, let's do this for an hour. You know, it's like reading 20 pages a day or something like that. You realize that it's just not that much work. Don't be intimidated by it. And plus, when you're making music with your friends, it's fun, so it's not that hard to be disciplined.
In a moment, I'm going to play I Love College. That's the track that a lot of people know you for. So before I bring that track up, is there anything that you want to say about this song?
Man, this is a great time capsule for me. I mean, there's nothing fabricated. There's nothing, you know, about this record that I regret. It's just, you know, a lot very soon. And for me, that's been my challenge on how to deal with it. You know, it's been really fun, to be honest with you, dealing with people's perspectives and trying to introduce yourself through music. It's not always easy to do. So, you know, this is a record, a celebratory record. If anyone comes to a show, it embodies women, dancing, drinking. There's nothing wrong with a little bit of college life. What's up? This is Asher Roth, and you're listening to The Interview Show with Scott Wood. I ain't going out like a sucker, no way. I'm nice right now, man. I feel good. If you have a drink, would you please put it in the air? That party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed, but my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I wanna go to college for the rest of my life. Sip Bankers Club and drink Miller Lite. On Thursday and Tuesday night ice. And I can get pizza, $1 a slice. So fill up my cup, let's get fucked up. I'm next on the table, who want what? I am champion at beer pong. Allen Iverson, Akeem Olajuwon. Don't even bounce, not in my house. Better hope you make it, otherwise you naked. Time isn't wasted when you're getting wasted. Woke up today and all I could say is, that party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I wish we taped it. I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed, but my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I love college. Hey, I love drinking. Can't tell you what I learned from school, but I can tell you a story or two. Yeah, of course I learned some rules, like don't pass out with your shoes on, and don't leave the house till the booze gone, and don't have sex if she's too gone. When it comes to condoms, put 2 on, then tomorrow night, find a new joint, hold the beer bong, nothing wrong with some fun, even if we did get a little bit too drunk.
Time isn't wasted when you're getting wasted. Woke up today and all I could say is that party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it.
I wish we taped it.
I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed, but my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I love college.
If everybody would please put their drink as high as they can, as high as they can, and repeat after me. Chug, 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 chug. Freshmen, 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 freshmen. Do something crazy, do something crazy, do something crazy, do something crazy. Keg stand, keg stand. Keg stand, keg stand.
That party last night.
Man, I love college. I love it.
That party last night.
Alright, everybody, I gotta head back to class for a little bit.
That party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it.
You know what's going down.
I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke.
You're all invited.
But my good friends,
bring your
is
friends.
All I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I love college.
Do I really have to graduate, or can I just stay here for the rest of my life?
Welcome back to the interview show. This is Scott Wood, your host. You just heard I Love College by a guy called Asher Roth. I'm sitting beside him in his tour van. I'd love it if you could say a few words about this track.
I love college. Hey. I love drinking. Hey. I love women. Hey. I mean, you know, there's not much more you need to say. Pretty much says it all.
Back in the days of your first record, you got compared to Eminem a lot, and he even dissed you on a track.
Quit acting salty. I was counting on you to count me out. Ask Asher Roth when he roundabout dissed me to shout me out. Thought I was history. Well, goddamn honky, that compliment's like backhanded a donkey. Good way to get your ass socked in the mouth. Nam off
it. What's it like to have somebody that you admire and are often compared to call you out like that?
Pretty tight, man. You're on the map, and you're on wax for forever. So, pretty cool, man. I'm into it.
How often do you listen to that track?
Honestly, man, I heard the diss. I wasn't really big on M's new album. I wasn't really big on the latest work, you know. So, but you know, M's a G, man. He's a legend.
I've read that at shows, a lot of your devoted fans want to hang out with you and freestyle for you to get critiques.
It happens. I mean, kids are definitely, you know, definitely, well, especially in the younger kids. I remember I wrote Lupe, like, yo, Lupe, listen to my rhymes. I mean, that's just kind of the communal side of it. So, yeah, kids will definitely be like, hey, check it out. But, critique-wise, there's nothing, you know, you just got to do your thing. There's nothing I can tell you to do or not to.
Can you tell me about your sweetest fan that's come up to you?
My sweetest fans probably from Germany, which is really cool because you're not there in their backyard, and then you realize kind of how powerful music can be when you can connect with someone where English isn't even their first language. Just such a sweet girl, and you know, introduced herself very shy and just has followed along. You know, what's really tight is people who were introduced through something from I Love College and then stuck with it even though I wasn't necessarily killing it on radio and, you know, dominating the charts, where it kind of gives you validation on why you're a fan of somebody. When someone's going through hard times and dealing with what they're dealing with and you still stick by their side, that to me is kind of priceless. And without people like these fans, I mean, this is the Roth girl, you know, that I'm talking about. So Janine is her name. And without people like that who kind of give you the, you know, they're just like, they give you the motivation to keep going. Without them, I don't know if I'd still be rocking.
Asher Roth, thank you very much for taking some time out of your day and spending it with me sweating very horribly in your tour van. Thank you. I appreciate it sincerely. At the end of the show, I'd love it if you could pick one of your tracks and talk a bit about it as I bring up that music.
Scott, I really enjoy sweating so closely to you. It was nice. You know, let's kick off the first song from the record RetroHash, Parties at the Disco. It's featuring ZZ Ward. It's a record that to me embodies kind of the the vibe and sets the tone for RetroHash. Very windows down, if you will, which we need to do right now. Cruise around the streets with the windows down on a beautiful day. So Scott, you and I can do that while we bump Parties at the Disco.
All right, Parties at the Disco by Asher Roth off his record, RetroHash. Asher, thank you very much for being on my show.
Thank you. What's up? This is Asher Roth, and you're listening to The Interview Show with Scott Wood.
Call me feeling wishful. Think about the oh, 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 oh. Parties at the disco. If I could fly, oh, fly, oh, fly, oh, fly away from here.
Everything around, so every now and then, feeling like I'm out of town. Gotta chill, sit down, remember how to be a child. Wide eyes with a smile, what, when, where, how. Style so nostalgic, lisping a cowlick. Jump to the moon with a spoon and a spatula. Trapped in the past, thinking how do we get back to it. Got that funny, funny feeling at last. Feeling like,
oh, 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 oh. Call me feeling wishful. About the oh, 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 oh. Parties at the disco. If I could find, I would find, I would find, I would find a way.
Give some, so pick one. Lose some, you win some, so have fun. Don't stress or do flips, just press on. Moon twist, the shoe fits, so step on. Keep walking down the path that you meant for. Dog barking at the cat is essential. We will always come back to the threshold. But first, you gotta let go.
Get out the oh, 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 oh. Call me feeling wishful.